beautiful shot of the night sky over Gangneung Hockey Center. And this inside, it's a 5th-8th place classification game in the para ice hockey. Norway and Japan. Norway with the win and two losses. Japan still yet to get a victory in PyeongChang in this Paralympic hockey tournament. And it has been deep and it has been wide in quality, as it's going to be Norway who takes to the ice first. They in the red with the traditional Norg across the front, a little bit of blue trim and white as well. And they hit the ice with enthusiasm, as you might expect. A very proud hockey nation. Likewise for Japan, as they will now take their position on this stage. And of course, the white and the red, as you see. So 4 years ago, remember Japan in the Paralympic Games in Sochi, not a part of that competition. So here back at the top of the table, and this is the game that you want to win in order to get yourself through competing for fifth place. Is the highest position available to you now remaining in the tournament. Jonathan Morrison, the referee, and the two Czech linesmen, Vanek and Wesley, to take the duties in this one. Officially, this is game 14 overall in the tournament. And yes, as you heard, there's Sudo coming across to shake hands as the captain, as Norway, their final moments of preparation. You see the intensity. That is Rolf Einar Pedersen there on the right side of your screen. He is always locked in, a perennial Paralympian. Nine-time Paralympian, to be exact. And this is the moment, as Kjell Christian Hamar will take his position in Norway's goal. That's a great shot there. We haven't had to have too many reviews of such of goals. Espen Hedga in charge. And this now for Norway, as we look back across 2014. They finished fourth in 2014. Best they can do now is fifth. Their lineup, Hamar in goal. Number three, Rolf Einar Pedersen is really the one to be looking for up front. They've got a number of different options offensively. It's Nakagita, all smiles and grace there to shake the hand of the American Morrison. Fukushima will take goal. Sudo, the captain, their real player on the blue line. Daisuke Uehara, as far as minutes played, he's the one that you'll be expecting to see a lot of the time out there. Hamar, with the 75.56 save percentage, is okay. The 6.95, maybe not so much. And we look at the other side, Fukushima, 7.95 goals against as an average, and 72.73. So those numbers are a reflection of why they're competing in this particular game, as realistically, to be at the top in this Paralympic competition, you need to have save percentages up over 90%. And this now, a great shot of the purpose-built venue for these Paralympic Games in PyeongChang. The stage is set for Japan and Norway to take each other on. The victor will go through and to compete for fifth place. Magnus Bogle, 1-2, watch, 3 points in three games, two of those as goals. He's an option offensively, and the most notable one. Norstoga, another goal. Takahashi with a goal for the Japanese, and that's their lone goal. So offense has been hard to come by. It's a great shot inside the Norwegian bench, and also of the picks at the end of these stick blades that they use to propel themselves around the ice, almost like you would find on skis, just to really get into the ice and push along these sleds. We are ready to go in the classification match. Underway, it's Japan in white with the red numbering and red trim. It's Norway in the predominantly all red. Very vivid colors and scenes there as we're underway in the first period of the para ice hockey in the classification round. Setting the stage for just in fact one place. These teams will be competing for what will be their final resting spot as far as their ranking in 2018. PyeongChang. As for a moment, it's just a little bit of calm as the Japanese. measured in their approach. Daisuke hands it over, and a shot here from Solberg. Fukushima makes the first save of the hockey game. And it happens when you get a little too widespread coming out of your zone, and the angle is predicted by the forechecking forward from the offensive side. And you turn it over in those places right in the heart of the slot area. You are playing with fire. That shot, though, taken quite comfortably, in fairness, by Fukushima. As Norway was keeping in, there is a loose stick out on the ice. Need to navigate that. It's part of the shrapnel of the equipment. And now a penalty has been taken by Japan. As Norway have really set the stage here in the opening minute. The shot on goal, and now bringing about a penalty to be taken. And now Norway will benefit from a player advantage. They'll have a power play. Nakamura comes across, and he just gets, I would suggest, probably a holding of the opponent call there. He just has that right hand out long enough, and then a little disheveled in the end was Martin Bjarnes holding an opponent exactly as the call. And off the draw, they take it. Pedersen will just rotate. See how high they are, electing just to stretch this Japanese defensive structure. Trying to pull it away as much as possible from the front of goal. You're going to increase your chances of getting shots through. But that's one of the challenges with para ice hockey, is that they can't do the sled very quick, so if you're in the shooting lane, you're unlikely to stay there. As this will be moved across, so you need to open up those channels for which to get a shot in on goal. Pedersen, good offload there against the board. Does he love the game or what? Oh, this is a good shot from Barnes there. Pedersen, 48 years young, on the puck right now. As it moves across to the near side. And here's Pedersen. Maybe a chance to shoot. He'll come around and wrap it. Trying to bang it off Fukushima. Didn't quite have the angle. Need to come out in front of that goal line. Quite got there. Inside of a minute now on his power play. Is now Pedersen again. This is the conduit for the offense in many ways for Norway. Sets the table as the puck runs through him. He assesses the best options available to this Norwegian side. There's a good shot, Nicole! How about that? From nowhere, it's Audun Bakke, and on the power play, he puts a dart to the top left corner of Japan's goal, and they take the lead, Norway. I don't know if Fukushima knew much about that. We didn't either. As it's just a flick of a wrist and whammy right in the top left corner. That is a half hitch and a full strike. Weissett, the assist as well. Officially power play goal at 2:25. Audun Bakke gets the party started for Norway. And in this tournament, it's his second goal. So he's just doubled his margin there with the flick of a wrist. And this will now be marshaled around by the Japanese on the ensuing face-off and see if they can try to impact on this Norwegian defense. There, catches, Morrison, the referee. Norway are very proud hockey country. Have a way of, in many ways, punching above their weight. Maybe they wouldn't say that in this competition. For them, fifth place is the best that they're going to be able to finish. And that's one step back from where they were 4 years ago. Keeping themselves involved and always in touch. shorter stuff because, you know, he could have gone a little bit longer and go to what maybe is a preferred position, but he trusted his shot and he took it and he saw the daylight. No need to open wide the barn door. You see enough space in which to get three horses through. Japanese keeper. So for Japan, only scoring one goal in the tournament up until this point is, of course, disappointing. But Japan in these games, they weren't a part of them 4 years ago. They were a part, however, of the 2015 World Championships in Buffalo, and they finished eighth in that competition. 2017, the World Championships here in Gangneung. They were not a part of that, so they're always on the cusp on Japanese as to staying up in A pool or maybe slipping down, having to re-qualify. So this is territory that they're used to. Look at the goal again. It's a goal scorer's goal, that. It's just a really smart hockey play, and you don't shoot that puck and make that choice of a shot selection unless you understand fully the dynamics of ice hockey and the movements of the goalkeeper and the movements and quickness of deception with the flick of the wrist. You don't always have to be an A-plus position or an A-plus position. You can shoot from a B or a C position and still get an A. And that's what you saw right there from Audun Bakke. Pedersen. The offload is shunted forward. It's like a shuffleboard style where it doesn't quite work out. As this was played in by Kukka. On the stick of Wataru Mori, but Mori doesn't have it for long. As Norway will just come through some speed. That's the impressive part here. Another shot. Fukushima gets it, a blocker to it. Just snuffs that one out. Contact on the board over there. Now, the other way, here comes Japan. This looks like he's returning to some interest here. Into the corner, the first one to it, and then probably the little guy in Pedersen. Trying to get Pedersen in a little big body out here. And now just keep an eye on you. Thank you. For Japan, they can't hold it in the offensive zone. these players. By the red back in the jam. As this is round again behind the Norway. This looks a little bit like they're putting on a theatrical performance here. More about the movements and sort of aligning together than it is about actual purpose going forward offensively. This is golden, that's a strike, as they find themselves a second goal. And that was continuous possession, punctuated with a flurry of power. Norway enjoying proceedings so far. Fukushima, he'd like to close his eyes. As that was really sharp from Magnus Bogle. And then he lays it off to this man here, and he just weaves into prime real estate in front of Fukushima. And if you're in that kind of position, and your name is Rolf Einar Pedersen, you're expected to put the puck into the back of the twine. .523 remains in this first period of play. Daisuke, who just now played in. So Pedersen is an even strength goal at 9:37. This is Magnus Bogle and Andre Dostova. The first goal was on power play at 2:25. Have they got a third one? Oh, that's a pretty good question there. As it's over from Lloyd R. Solberg. Solberg is one of these reliable and dependable assets, offensive assets for Norway. A whole lot of change in their personnel. You can see a lot of change. Some of the well-established countries in the sport. Some rotation maybe through the North American lines. Because there's a little bit more supply of personnel. And here at Daisuke, he has back to retirement from which he took in 2010. And his own charity initiative, and now is, well, looking at supporting young children. And now he's been encouraged to come back. And he's been back here, performing very well indeed. Kuma guy logged big minutes as well. Japanese. This is the goal for Pedersen. He had the defender really just kind of doing a drive-by. Pedersen with so much control and core strength. Just contours himself in. Looks like riding a wave. And just takes the right wave at the right time. And when you're in those positions, and you're really good at what you do, good things happen. Hedge right there with the very Norwegian beard and the hairstyle to boot as well. I'm envious. The rollover here, a shot. Fukushima catches that with the glove and just sets that down and just traps it in there quite comfortably. Japan electing to have a wholesale line change of all five players coming off. You know that there could be some offensive pressure here from Norway and want to make sure that they are as fresh as possible with their personnel. Daisuke plays this on a little bit in advance, but that's okay. Of course, he's going to drop it forward. This is mental. He's got the eyes on his shoulder. Battle for possession. Japan can break that up.
Sound.
on the first 15 minutes of play. Two goals for Norway, well earned, as Audun Bakke with a goal scorer's shot and a completion at 2:25. The power play goal, the assist there to Oyseth, and then Pedersen just running shotgun with Magnus Bogle up the length of the ice, an even strength goal. And he just does what Rolf Einar Pedersen does. It's 2-0 for Norway over Japan in the classification game for 5th-8th place. It's 15 minutes gone. We will pause and join you ahead of the second intermission, or the second period, rather, coming up in a moment.
I put my spirit into the test.
the first period in the books as the 2-0 scoreline for Norway stands. And it's the 7 shots that they took in order to get those 2 goal return. Japan, unfortunately, have not got a shot as yet in the game. And therefore, of course, remain scoreless as we are in the first intermission break. And the kiss cam is always a crowd pleaser. There you look at it. It's the 1-from-1 on the power play that was really quite potent as Audun Bakke scores the first one. And he just, it was just a supreme goal. And the reason why I say it even more so is because he takes a risk there of missing the net, starting the other team's breakout, and being quite disappointed with the return. Maybe he could put himself into an even better position, but he had confidence in his shot, and he got rewarded for it. That was the first goal for Norway. As we'll have a little look in a sec here back over that opening 15 minutes. This was turned over. This was in the first minute here, and just maybe a little bit of a sign of what was coming. Solberg gets a good shot off. Fukushima makes a comfortable save, and another effort here. It's a one-time shot taken by Oseth, and maybe a chance there could have been touched in front by Klakegg, and then Audun Bakke. When I said it was a half hitch and a full return, and what I mean by that is he kind of just flinched with the body pump here, a little bit that contour, and then makes that elevated shot up and into the top of the goal. And there you see the lean in from the coaches. They are the biggest fans of these players. They spend the entire journey with them to get to this world-class level at the Paralympic Games. And of course, their success reflects the coach's success, but what ends up happening, Pedersen with just a violent strike, really, as he comes right through and then just rams it high up in the net. But you can appreciate a coach. It becomes more than just a job, doesn't it? You are vested in these players' lives and entirely in their journeys, their triumphs, and maybe some of their failures. It's Pedersen right there. A full reward for being calm and measured alongside Bogle. Bogle led that whole rush and was talking about puck possession time and how seldom do players really hold it for longer than 2 seconds. But he had it for like 5 or so, carried it all the way through, and then it was the handoff to Pedersen, and Pedersen did the rest. Norway returned to the ice first.
And now welcome back to the ice, Team Japan.
Norstoga getting a secondary assist on the Pedersen goal. Japan return to action. Hopefully, for their sake, they've got a little bit more offense to offer this matchup. As the Japanese flags with pride being waved within the Gangneung Hockey Center. A lot of youngsters in the building and have been throughout the course of this event and across all of the Paralympic sports. They really have been very clever, PyeongChang and the organizing committee, in making sure to plant the seed with the youth and the potential players of tomorrow, whether it be in the Olympic Games or in the Paralympic sport. This has served its purpose well in PyeongChang. As Shao Christian Hamar works from post to post to limber up and prepare. And the most to watch the action because he's not been overly busy so far in this one. Norway are in firm command of this hockey game. But as they say, a 2-0 lead is the worst lead in hockey. 1 goal from Japan and things change very quickly. Thank you. underway for the second period as they've whipped this crowd into a frenzy. It's Japan in white with the red numbers against Norway, as you see, predominantly in all red. They've got the white numbering. And it's a shovel in on Shell Christian Harm. Will that count as a shot? I'm not sure. Officially, a shot is a goalkeeper has to do something to prevent it from accessing his own goal. He might have had enough of it to get in, but here comes Pedersen.
Breakaway,
And then Rolf Einar Pedersen comes back. Tick, attack, and here comes the toe. As right past Shell Hamar. And how about this for the Japanese making the most of their opportunities? They have one official shot and they have a goal. Impressive, impressive. So now, this is worst lead in hockey. You're only just one shot away. What about that play? As we've got goals coming from curious places, and Magnus Bogle from behind the goal finds a way to perfectly open up the Japanese keeper. Again, he is sparked up. Look at this, around the wrap. Oh, is that nice? The elevation too. He throws the brakes on, which you need to, in order to just get planted in behind it to elevate it. If you're still going at top speed, you just kind of lose control and force takes you away from it, but he throws the brakes on as best he can. Now, that's a pretty special move for Magnus Bogle. In the sport of para ice hockey, that's as skillful and as well orchestrated a finish as you're gonna get from that type of movement. Bogle. He likes that one. I like that one. Pretty sure you did as well. You're a fan of the sport. It's pretty tough though for the Japanese. You just get their second goal of the tournament. Start to feel okay, they're within a shot. And then Bogle just comes around and delivers that, puts a little bit of salt right in the wound. Norway. Delivered along across the offensive blue line with some speed here. Pedersen in the space. Pedersen will shoot from there. Oh, he's done it high and hard. Oh, it's so precise. It's so fine. It'll make you lose your mind. As look at the Norwegian bench and the players likewise with Pedersen. Oh, he's all smiles. That's not always the expression you see in Rolf Einar Pedersen's face. Often he can get a little bit disgruntled, a little bit frustrated that things aren't going their way, but this is really signature stuff here from the 9-time Paralympian. Bing, right inside the top. And he has gone back and really coiled into that one. His back swing, if you will, ahead of that, he knew what he was launching. And he got it off real quick. Right here, Norway with a double punch right to the chops of the Japanese. Maybe one right in the midsection, the other one square on the jaw. And the Japanese right now are reeling in the ropes. You gotta be careful here, they don't fall out through the ring ropes the way it's going. If they get a fifth one here, that could be lights out. Okay, just working his way. Doing the best he can, but he's got Norwegians on him. Like flies on a rip rope. There's another shot. And that'll just make its way out into the neutral zone. And sent in by Norway. Try to chase this into the corner, and they're the first one to do it. First one's off the scene. Oh, they can't. Look at this from Norway. They are too good right now. And they are putting together passes and scoring goals like they are doing it for fun. And it's not too much fun right now for Fukushima. As he feels like he's getting pumped up like a tire. Varnas. Right in Audun Bakke. Audun Bakke's got the quick, cool hand loop delivery. Right here. That is sharp. And really, oh, almost a little bit like Dirty Harry. He is lethal from range. And he just fires another bullet right into the back of the Japanese goal. Pedersen will now get onto the puck again. Norway, oh, Pedersen's got all of the trickery there, but the guy's not playing it. Just put your magic pad away. And he just tries to separate men from puck. Takahak looking to do the same thing as well. Takahak just scores that fantastic goal in the build up of the situation together. And then right afterwards, just whammo. It's been a trio of goals from the Norwegians that'll just make your socks roll up and down. Hard to believe. And they've got it in their locker, there's no doubt, but it's the way it's taken. The Pedersen one is just so imperfect. Audun Bakke again, you can make a film about the quick pitching shot, how to score it, where to score it from. And then the other one from Magnus Bogle. The way he comes around the goal and then just throws and breaks on, but he was going so hard that he ended up kind of doing the southpaw. Double southpaw out of it. There's a shot, goes up around the boards here. Oh, he throws it enough to get enough bases behind the shot to elevate it. But three very interesting elevated shots from Norway. And equally just things of beauty as far as pure hockey execution. It's now behind Norway's goal again. Shorts and take that puck with him, but then he offloads it. Bad hit. We almost like the full court press on here. They're applying the forecheck. Now they're applying the physical check. And then for Norway here. Up the boards. They at least bring some more action. Here's Pedersen. Don't bet against him. Oh, he doesn't get all of it. And you can feel the rise in excitement there and anticipation. No more than his own. He would have been just locked in and wanting to get himself a hat trick there. Pedersen, the ultra competitor. This was the Takahashi goal. And that, in fact, was really impressive. And then Bogle comes and does his thing. And then right here from Pedersen, right to the left, and then right around the back of the Japanese goal. And then Audun Bakke, no invitation required. He just wastes little time, and that quick release is a real skill set. Blackhang, he'll come forward a little bit. He was an option earlier. He's in the crease. Could have maybe tapped one in there. He hasn't got any points as yet in the tournament. So Hammer gets the assist on the Pedersen second goal. Audun Bakke and Schwartz-Barnes and Magnus Bogle gets the assist on that. That happens at 20:02. Japanese goal from Takahashi and then Mori with the assist. And that was shorthanded. And then that happened at 18:20. But then 18:20, 18:34, 18:55, and 20:02. So really, it's a minute 42 seconds. We saw from the Japanese goal. The Norwegians just grabbed this game right by the scruff of the neck. Dilton in the corner at the moment. Well, they're trying to get things going. They lay it on here. They do. It's back. And just this rotation around. A little snapper. And it will, in fact, just go wide of the goal. And it's more the snap shot and the wrist shot than the shots of choice. Don't really get an opportunity to do the slap shot. It's just such a snapshot, such a wide spectrum of success. Back and gifted to them by the Japanese. It's that break just down the left side here. Second period, I haven't seen anything. One shot, one goal. Now, is this going to turn into something? One last man standing, though, for the Japanese, just to keep that at bay for the moment. Solberg. Side of the rink to the other, and this one we played out, trying to connect it, and it can't be. A good one, idea from Moiseth, that now the captain, Sudo, will just take this puck and gives it back to the teammate, but again, they can't quite link those passes together consistently, and that's been the challenge. And Pedersen throws the brakes on there and picks up some snow. This is just a little too aggressive. Out now, Fukushima. He throws the big bear paw on it. And he'll bring about a face-off just to his left. 4:51, as you can see, remaining in the second period. Both teams return to their face-off positions. It's in the defensive zone for Japan. As the crowd enjoys the in-house entertainment, the music is what sets them alight. They love to dance in Korea, and they really get involved, and they are passionate about sport, about their own home country, but they've been passionate about all of the teams here, and enjoying them likewise. Very gracious hosts, and have put on quite a party in PyeongChang across the two sporting events, the Olympics and now the Paralympics. And Erstoga is giving a little bit of a prompt to the referee there, says, well, it should stay inside the zone, shouldn't it, face off? It does exactly that. Takahashi, the goal scorer for Japan, and he, in doing so, that's his second goal of the tournament, and those are the only two goals that Japan has scored. He is the lone goal scorer. Double service. This is now for Norway to come forward. The pass just gets beyond. And the goal for Einstein as a result. And good ambition to try to achieve it. The execution that wasn't quite as sharp. Continues. This looked like Pedersen maybe was going to be on. And a possibility there of trouble again inside the Japanese goal. Norway enjoying this. They're in a great position. Oh, it's just like a bar of soap. And it's in the shower. It's not just coming out of the package. That one was a little slipper. Holding back to Bakke. And he does the full 360 degree pump. And Norway again, just finding and almost just riding. Background there, Japanese trying to get into a defensive position. That is a guy. And it's now Japan doing up. And Tatsuke comes up with it. The offload is loose and easy. Again, Japan inside on the board, halfway up. That's an offside, as you saw on the far side. See what was available. A little bit of an east-west movement across the line generally brings about that frustration. You always want to, as an offensive player, hit that offensive blue line and be released to do your job, whether that's supporting the puck carrier, whether it's being available as a pass option, going to the net. You always want to hit it with some speed and make sure that not having to be disrupted, held up. Trying to take advantage of it. The speed helps to support that. It's just now being volleyed back and forth between the two nations. Pedersen just be happy just to keep it in his clutches. He loves the game. Pseudo back. Sharp turn off the expressway and gets going north. Possibility. And Samar just settles things down, but Japanese were in hot pursuit. Shot. Samar just has to kind of double clutch for it. He ends up kind of getting a little bit of a rough ride as a result. Bad with a shot in, and this time now Hamar is laying down. He's relaxed there. A spinning move here off this faceoff. It cannot initially be controlled, it can this time. Hamar has made three saves where he looks like he's laying on a beach towel and getting some sunshine. Very relaxed. To the left as they look forward. Oh, there, another testing shot. So Japan, as that one just goes up, and I believe out of play, yes, it does. And it just kind of happened quite quickly. might have just shaved the post there. And it went out, so it wasn't touched. So Japan has the face-off out of the offensive zone into the neutral zone. Take that. It's a chance for us to pause as we will join you ahead of the third period coming up. four shots on goal in that second period for Japan. Five for Norway. They get a goal, do the Japanese, but that starts proceedings where you basically waken up or awoken the giant that is the Norwegians, who just came back and scored three goals just as quick there. As the faceoffs just marginally in the command of the Norwegians. And they're one from two from the power play opportunities that they've had. But the shots in total are to their advantage, 12-4. As there was no shots from Japan in that opening period, but now they've got the four. And I thought that goal was going to help them along the way, but the Norwegians just lifted off on the back of it and put a trio of goals quickly on the board in that second period. And this is a look at the Takahashi goal, as it's down and then back again, isn't it? And a well-taken effort there, as it's put onto the tape, and Hori gives the service, and then Takahashi, that's the first shot of the game for Japan, stays with it and converts. And then this the goal right afterwards, coming right around. And from our vantage point, it looked like maybe had he just kind of slotted it down low, but he elevates it. That's really impressive power, because your momentum's all leading away from the net, and to get underneath the puck and then to be able to elevate it too. That's great body control, just great strength. And then Pedersen is just given too much time, and then he goes to the left hand. And that's a real weapon, to be able to shoot equally with both hands. And he has that in his locker, as he looked like maybe he's going to go with the right, and then he just turned it around and left. And it's just around the back of the hammock, just like you'd want to shoot it. I mean, that is potent. Just the way it goes in, just holds tight to the mesh even. It's just inserted with total purpose. And this great save made by Fukushima. As Pedersen comes back, and he's on the cusp of getting a hat trick in this game. He'd love to have it. He's got the two. And his numbers for the tournament, maybe not fully reflective of his body of work, is he's got the two goals from this game. He had the one assist coming in as the reflection of what Pedersen has been able to achieve with brilliance and school scoring. That is his calling card, as Norway will make their way out onto the ice, and with great energy, Japanese maybe not as vibrant coming back out onto the ice, a little bit delayed. So the linesman right there making sure that it's only the starting players that get to engage with the ice ahead of the drop of the puck. The rest of the personnel must take their positions on the benches in readiness for what looks like at the moment a commanding Norwegian performance. It is the chance to compete for fifth place that's on the line here in this matchup. And the Japanese need to hold their nerve. They have been in this snakes and ladders game between Pool A and Pool B, relegated and then having to earn their way back in again. They do not want to get into that. It looks like that'll be a contest for them potentially in their next matchup. That's really going to determine just what their destiny is after PyeongChang 2018 in these Paralympic Games. Fukushima still with smiles on his face. Michelle Christian Hamar is rather on his own. He hasn't had a lot of activity, so he's there deep in his own thoughts. As the Japanese together, they wait as the game clock counts down. As we get ready to finish proceedings here on day number five in the pair ice hockey. It gets loud, and it's very crowded here. The Koreans love a good sporting event. You can see what the athletes think there. They can hardly believe it. excellent. Passion connected. That's what you're getting. Getting this nation of young people watching on this team. This role will be the in-house entertainment, will be the action of the ice, being here with the friends, having this team.
Careful!
All of that connection, contact with the game, with a new sport for many of the young guys looking at it, and the memories that will last for a lifetime now. As this, as they get wrapped up, it's 5-on-5. Well, nice here. You won this sometimes. I guess probably going to hand it out. Just got to make sure. Contact here, Japanese mainly. They're taking out the first Norwegian cross line. Norway now. Second look, touch in. It's going to be a deflection, a redirection. There is neither. Side. got his hat trick. And you're indicating from the bench there, throw your hats. Well, the prices of hats here in the Megastore, maybe a best keeper. As Pedersen, it looked for a second as though he was, there was only one place he was going to go. He was going to go and shoot himself. He wanted that hat trick, and Fukushima is beaten cleanly right into the top of the jam jar. You see Pedersen, he's just like a predator, just looking at his prey, just waiting for the opportunity to sort of strike. And he got it there. He wasted no time. All three of his goals have been equally elevated and powerful. Puck is dropped. It goes. Pedersen will get the collection. Well, he gets the goal. Let's just see exactly how college. There's going to be the change as well in goal. Fukushima has come out for Japan, and Mochizuki has now made his way in. So a little bit of distribution of the ice time here. And he had played 20 minutes and 11 seconds prior to that. It's now 13-5 in total shots on goal. And Orstoga picks up another assist as he and Boga get the two assists on the passing goal. An even strength one at 35-28. All smiles for the Norwegians. They enjoy it. They like hair gel too. As you see some real waves of feathers there. The two Norwegian coaches. Sharp-dressed man. Everybody loves one. As this outside the blue line. Japan just wanting to up the ante here. Try to amplify their game. The game so far is, it's been acoustic. They need a little bit of amperage to it. With the lone assist on the one goal for Takahashi. It's a little bit better. That's just deflected in. Black tape. Plays it around to tight to the board. It's out front. Black tape. Make sure that it gets out of the zone. Pass is the challenge to put together. It's half a dozen now. Two goals. Three in the second. build from in order to make sure that they hit that opportunity in 2 days' time in their final classification match for where they might finish in this tournament. They get it as strong and as much of an underpinning of good positive play as any team would require to make sure that they can go out and have the right platform built from. Space. He's got more movement right now. And you might see the stage of dancers. And it all going on. The challenge being in the Japanese. Lulu's coming. And they return to base. They cross the blue line. There's a chance now. Norway trying to link on to Winston. It's just going to be beyond their retention on that sequence. They're now doing their best to be deliberate and hope to maybe turn over again. Daisuke has come a long ways, but he's just going to be broken off that full possession quite comfortably there. This now, the long shot forward. A little bit like a curling shot, this one. A movement to an area or territory and just forcing the Japanese to go back and work hard again. Maybe in the process, it doesn't matter, but it's maybe Japan, Norway would maybe bring an opportunity out of it. So, 3-28, Misawa is an ever present, going through just the ice time. Over the first two periods of play, it's Ichihara who's playing the most, 21-32. And then after that, it's the top line of Hori, Ihara, Takahashi, Kumagai, and Misawa. Misawa, 19-37. Average shift length, 2 minutes and 10 seconds. If you look back at some of the goals in this hockey game. Thing of beauty, just how world-class his finishing can be. Audun Bakke to take this draw. Equipment. They're suggesting Odin Bakke has it in his equipment. He's taken it to the benches. Here goes Jonathan Morrison in hot pursuit. He's going over there, and Audun Bakke's got it in his body. That's what we're looking to find here. Where has he? They need a new puck. They've got a new puck. And it's a timeout. Morrison has come over and indicated it. It's Japan calling it.
Team timeout. Team Japan.
Well, remember, with this inside 2 minutes remaining, 151 on the actual game clock, that this is a chance in live action here for the Japanese coach, Koji Nakakita, to remind his side of what they're trying to execute here ahead of having to then perform and do this in their final match, which will determine their position in PyeongChang. And he'll be talking about the importance of them focusing and doing the right things to just see this game through, not concede any more goals against, because those same questions will be asked of them in a game that will really determine their future in 48 hours from now. So this is what it's about. Japan come out, and they've had a good think through as to what they need to do and how they want to go about executing it. And this defensive zone face-off here is an important face-off to win for the Japanese. That we do see, the helmets are all coming off. Two shots apiece in that third period. And the one goal to Pedersen. Shots in total to six, and the 1-for-2 in the power play, and those the tallies of the game. The very commanding Norwegian performance. The proud Japanese team will now be in a fight for their Paralympic life when they take on Sweden in their matchup. Or seventh position. Very impressive Norwegian performance in the 5th-8th place classification game. They started things off with a couple of goals, a power play, and an even strength likewise. Rolf Einar Pedersen, the stalwart of the Norwegian program, he scores a hat trick in this one and leads by example. They, as a result, with a 6-1 victory over Japan, will go and contest for fifth position, and they'll take on the Czech Republic in that matchup. For Japan, they'll take on Sweden for seventh position. A great journey is fast coming to an end in the para ice hockey tournament from PyeongChang, but there's still lots more to come. Join us in the days still remaining. It's only day 5.